Hi, welcome back. With the interest in lure fishing recently, whether it's pike, whether it's game course, sea fishing, whatever you do, the multiplier reel has kind of come back into the fore again. Now, everybody's probably heard of the Abu Ambassadeur reel, these types here. Initially Swedish made, super high quality, and long regarded as one of the best standard multipliers on the market, bar none. The Ambassadeur collector's market is huge. It's also very involved and very intricate. So, take for instance, if you had this Abu Ambassadeur 5000 multiplier, very nice, it has four screws. If it had three screws, it would be worth more or less. That has two white handles. If it had one white handle and a counterbalance, it'll be worth more or less. If it has a level wind or a spool core in white or a spool core in red, it'll be worth more or less. If the foot number is of a specific digit code, it'll be worth more or less. So it's a very, very involved subject. There are books and books on the Ambassadeur collecting scene, and it can be a great place to be. The good news about Ambassadeurs, there are lots of models to go at. So whether you're a £50 buyer for a relatively modern Ambassadeur casting reel, you can see the difference in shape and style, you can still buy something. If you move up to the couple of £100 bracket or £300 bracket, you go to the slightly older EBU Fabriken reels, the Record reels, 2100 Sport, which are an absolute delight. They're Swiss watch inside, beautifully manufactured, but you can still buy these in the cases, with the tools, with all the accessories, for £200 to £300. A great investment. That's one to watch for in the future. If you say generally, I like lure fishing and I want to fish, they're all very usable. We have here a couple of examples by Hardy. This is probably one of the budget end as far as the collector is concerned at the moment, price-wise. The Hardy LRX is a fabulous piece of kit. Nickel and chrome plated, Prince of Wales feathers on the end here with the Royal Warrant. It's got a level wind, it's a smooth check, beautifully made. And you'll buy one of these in the, sort of 1 to 150 mark, comfortably 200 for mint in the box. That's the similar money now you're paying for a big pit reel, which is crazy. The minute you walk out the shop, your big pit reel is just halved, and this is just gaining value. And if you're particularly collectible on the Hardy side, you'd always want to have one of these HJS Hardy Jock Scott reels. Very similar, you'll notice, to the Record 2100. They're very similar in style, they're very similar in quality. The inside of this, should we take it apart, which I'm not going to do, is a Swiss watch. It's fabulous. It has brakes, drags, checks, star drags, beautifully made. Not common. Again, you're in the low hundreds for one of these, but future-wise, never gone down. And if I look back over the past 10 or 20 years, when these were £80 and £100 and £200 and £300, this is a good steady investment. Move back to the other end of the market again. We bring in good old J.W. Young. This is one of the Gildex reels. A little bit unusual about this is it has a folding foot, which not only allows it to get on some of the curious rod fittings that we have, because the foot folds and goes into a case, it stops the rod foot, the reel foot, sorry, being damaged and broken off. So it's kind of a lovely little trick that J.W. Young have done. These are available in two or three different colours, two or three different sizes. Nice when you get the original zip padded case with the Young's logo. Not a lot of money, sub £100, complete with case. So that's a good budget entry level multiplier to collect. And it would be wrong if we didn't bring in the USA contingent. This is Fluger of America, Fluger Supreme. They've done a lot of business with Alcox. They were kind of in bed with Alcox. And there was a story when I spoke to an Alcox employee called Master Salt. He used to say every 2 weeks the ship liners used to leave from England, going over towards New York and Pennsylvania, loaded with Alcox tackle. They'd fill up with Fluger tackle and bring it back home. And if you look into some of the early Alcox and Fluger catalogues, the content's identical. They're both selling each other's stuff. Well, why wouldn't you? Quality's great. It's a 50s, 60s reel. Very popular at the moment for pike fishing in particular. They've got a free spool drag system called the cubby drag on the end. It's twin handles, it's star drag, it's ratchet, it's level wind, it's got a lot. And again, you'll buy one of these with its bag and sometimes its tools, £75. Great collectible. It's not going down, so you can fish it all its life and get your money back plus a bit afterwards. And they're very tradable, especially in Europe. So good fun with multipliers. Doesn't have to be a lot of money. From £50 upwards, you can have a bit of fun. You can use them, collect them, and then sell or trade them at the end of it. So multipliers, good, solid collecting fun.